Hey, 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 and welcome to another episode of the Crew Podcast. I am your visionary, Queen Angela. And if you are a diva that's looking to amplify your voice and you're looking for a home, we have space for you. Come on over and join them divas of the airwaves and amplify your voice.
Are you a business expert ready to make a difference in the world of starving entrepreneurs? Join us for the Black Business Summit, streaming live on the
Oh, mercy, mercy me. All things ain't what they used to be now. Where did all the blue skies go? Poison is the wind that blows from the north, south, and east. Oh, mercy, mercy me. All things and what they used to be not.
At Wings of Transformation Publishing, we are committed to helping our authors reach their goals and pursue their dreams of becoming published authors. We work closely with each author to ensure a successful publishing experience. And we are dedicated to helping them tell their stories in the most meaningful and impactful ways. We look forward to putting you on the path to writing your book.
Hi, this is Liselle Powder from The Powder Room. Join me every fourth Sunday and fourth Monday at 8 p.m. for poetic
All right. Good night, everyone. This is Liselle Powder from The Powder Room coming to you tonight. And tonight I have a guest. Her name is Andrea Mason. All right. She is a very, very, how to say, professional coach. If you need any coaching advice, any coaching need, anything that you need to push you forward, to enhance, to grow, reach out to her. She's an exceptional coach, and also she is also with Les Brown, right? You
yes,
I am your mentor.
Yes, my coach, kindred spirit, and fellow adoptee. Yes, Les Brown.
Yes. So, Andrea, all right. I just want to ask a few questions to you. How did it all start? What drive, what passion, that zeal you that, you know, you got to be a coach, to be a motivational speaker? How did it all happen? How did it all start?
Yes, it all started when I was a young child. I was adopted from Colombia, South America during the cartel and came to the Americas at 11 months, weighing in at only 11 pounds. Wow. Now you would say, wow, that's amazing. That's 11 pounds per month. But if you think about it, I was welcomed with open arms with unconditional love. But kids can be cruel because I didn't look like my American parents. And when we were doing a project in school, they said, you don't look like your parents. I said, well, I was adopted. All excited about the treasure and being a gift for my parents. Then they said, well, if your parents don't love you, how can you love anybody else? So that's when it all started, Liselle. I decided to muster up the courage. And after being a victim of abuse and bullying all throughout the stages of my life, I decided to go from victim to victorious.
Yes, yes. And I think you have a book out with that, right?
Yes, I do. It is right here, Victim to Victorious. Les Brown had done the foreword to this, and it speaks about the good, the mishaps, but as Steve says, yes, absolutely. It can be found on Amazon as well as my website, andreamasons.com. And okay. It just talks about the path less traveled of the journey, which is that of my business, Press Play, Plan Life According to You.
Okay, great. Great. Let me see, you said that you were bullied. I could imagine how that must have felt like, being bullied and being chastised, and every minute you are trying to move up, every time you're trying to get forward, every time you're trying to grow in your passion, there is always somebody stamping you down. How was it like? How was it, you know, how can you overcome with all of these, you know, stuff facing you, you know? What was your strength and willpower to push and persevere?
My willpower was that of my parents. They gave me unconditional love. They welcomed me in their home. So I utilized two outlets. I used the outlet of music, the frequency of all different genres, whether it's classical to reggaeton to Latino and dancing. I love to dance. And then the other aspect... The other aspect was that of athletics. I wanted to be upon a team where I thrived with my skill set. So I was a soccer player. I was able to make varsity my freshman year and just learned how to be on a team, how we all had the same drive, determination, and dedication. And those were the outlets that helped me get through the heartaches and academic struggles that of school. So I see here, LaTonya. Oh, that's awesome. You're adopted as well. Oh, that's awesome. We are chosen. That's what makes us special.
Yes. That is so fabulous. I know you have been around speaking and talking about your story and sharing your passion and your dream and getting people to be aware of bullying, of discrimination, of, you know, any kind of abuse, you know. So you have seen yourself grown, you have seen yourself like speaking out and talking. How it has been, how has it fueled your life, transformed you to do more, like, you know, persevere and keep going?
Excellent question. Well, I was always behind the scenes. I dedicated over 2 decades plus and obtained degrees in social work and psychology. So I was understanding social work of the cultural diversities and backgrounds of individuals. Then the psychology to understand why we do what we do and don't do. And so as the world changed, I decided to make an investment in me. I decided, you know what? I'm going to go forefront and forward and be transparent and vulnerable. So as I was scrolling and the world was changing, everybody was confused. I was like that every day. I took my adversities and changed them into my identity. But as an adoptee, I was always looking for that missing piece in the puzzle. I felt like there was something I could do more or be more. So I'll never forget, I was just released from the previous employer that I was working for because of the change of the world and the shutdown and the closings, was unable to sustain the company. And I heard that famous voice that just warms your heart of Les Brown on social media saying, are you going through it or are you growing through it? And Liselle, at that moment, I made the first financial investment into myself and I went to the best of the best and I obtained his mentor and coaching. And I just took it, the bull by the horns, as being a Taurus, pun intended. I just decided that I have a story. I have a situation that no matter what gender, creed, belief system, we all live the book of life. And yes, my chapters can be found within my audience and help them thrive and go from victim to victorious. Because I failed at everything in life, school, relationships, self-esteem, you name it, I failed it. So I decided to fail forward and go to the top.
Yes. Oh my God, that is so excellent. That is great. Mm-hmm. When I'm off, when I get time, we'll talk a little bit more.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah, this is so exciting. Now, you said you have the book is out. You said it's on Amazon. I don't know if you want to leave it in the chat or if you want to, how people can reach you on social media, if they want to have you like for coaching, for any sort of advice or any kind of thing. If you want, you could put your stuff on and, you know, so people can reach out to you if you wish.
Absolutely. I'm going to put my link tree in the chat right now that has all the links to hire me for coaching, speaking events, booking events, as well as the links for my book. Let me see if I am able to do that. I'm not going to have to do it from the other device, so bear with me.
Sure.
Okay, so go ahead. We'll continue on in the interim.
Nice. This is so awesome. With that said, you know, even I believe there is always some trial that we, not only women, but people, men, children, society, that we have to be pushing. We have to see ourselves always rising to the top, always trying to, you know, reach somewhere. Because normally on mornings I do my lives, and that it didn't just happen because, you know, for me, I say to myself, live? Where everybody watching me? You know, everybody watching you, everybody listening to you.
Right.
At first I was kind of scared, and then eventually it started to grow and I just started to feel more confident in doing it, and my voice started, you know, flow with whatever, you know. And with everything that is going on, you know, what advice would you give for women? Even it might have some men too who may be going through some sort of abuse, some sort of mental dysfunction, you know, because I mean, we always look at a woman going through stuff. Of course, yes, we women go through stuff, but there are some men who are going through stuff, who are, you know, going through some sort of pain. It might be abusive, it might be, you know, some sort of dilemma that is having them at a place where they are not growing, they are not pushing forward. The system, the society, even where they are living, they tend to be drawn into the activities that is going on around them, and they can't seem to push themselves. What advice you would give to men or the women or children or young adults, you know, for them to persevere, to keep going?
Excellent question. And I can relate on all aspects because the stages of life, I was a child, an adolescent, a young adult, and so forth, what I've endured abuse and bullying. But what is amazing is the aspects of mental health. We have to break the stigmatism of mental health, that it's some sort of inpatient, lack of intellect. No, really what it is the external influences that you've mentioned before of media, programming, conformity, and the adversities of life. And so when I was growing up, I didn't have a strong familial feminine surrounding. My mom and my grandmother were very powerful, but as far as the social component, I hung around with the guys. I was the tomboy that was throwing the football, wearing the hoodie, and just running amok because, to be quite honest, to this day, I still don't cook, and I'm not really a fan of doing all the girly things because I just I have that competitive streak. I know I can challenge myself. So I do empathize with men because I've understood being surrounded by seven male cousins, very strong, of seeing the heartaches that men endure because, and I'll get to you ladies in a moment, so don't think I'm missing you out, but the men, they are taught to be protectors, taught to be this knight in shining, shimmering armor. But who's coddling them? Who's loving them? Who's allowing them to say, hey, you know, it's okay to share your feelings and emotions? Because what happens is we take for granted their power, their strength, their aggressiveness, and unfortunately, which comes bottled up and becomes abuse, is that they're not being understood. They're not being heard because they were taught, do not cry, do not get emotional. You're a simp, a wimp, or not, you know, a masculine individual. So for the men out there, allow yourself to speak emotions. Speak from your heart without fear. Because quite honest, I don't know about you ladies, but there's nothing more than an attractive man internally to relate to your emotions rather than just shutting you out and just saying, oh, you're a female, it's that time of the month, you're dramatic, when you can actually have that balance with the men out there. Now, for the women, yes, we are emotional, but that's what's the symbiotic relationship between men and women. That's the yin and the yang, that balance, you know. My relationships with men are usually a nurturing, empathetic time. But ladies, we give a hard time for the men when they get sick. Oh, he's being a little mama's boy. No, he doesn't know how to express his emotions when he's not equipped. The stigmatization yes. of masculinity. And then for the women, if you want to be cuddled, nurtured, always share your emotions. Why are we putting a stop or a pause on our emotions, saying dramatic, drama queen, or they have mental health issues? Well, if you look at the actual understanding of mental health, it's mental health of mind, body, spirit, and soul, that balance. Because think about it, when we have that cycle, regardless of age, post-perio or pre-menopause, ladies, we still have that hormonal balance and imbalance that is connected with the world, the moon and Mother Earth. And men, if you don't have a father figure, you're yearning for that not only hero in your corner, but now if you didn't have that male influence, now you have a shiro, which is your mother, which is respect, dignity, and, you know, be accountable and responsible, but we kind of limit and cap off the aggressive or the confident is what it should be in the men, having that confidence. Because, you know, like they say in TV and the cliches is men may be the head of the body, but the woman is the neck to show direction and light and vision.
Wow.
So that's why we have to be symbiotic. That's why we have to understand rather than compete. And ladies, let's stop competing with our fellow sisters and say, how can we come together, rise and unite and nurture? Yep. Liselle, you have mentioned, I have spoken on virtually on every single continent on this world. And what I've come to understand is that we want respect, unconditional love, and to be understood. And that goes for both dynamics, men and women, children and the elderly. Back to you.
Yes. Okay. That is fabulous. Oh my gosh. And I see a lot of comments. I don't know if you're seeing the comments.
Oh, yeah, I do. Yes. Oh, thank you, Patrice. Yes. LaTonya. Yes, absolutely.
Yes. Oh my God. That is fabulous. 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 Oh my God. That is so intense. You explained it so perfectly well. You understand?
Thank
and
you.
It is so true. We need that stability because when there is not that father figure, You mm-hmm. know, there is some family who is mothers alone, single mothers, and they hold right. their children mm-hmm. a grip, and they right. come out to be fabulous, and they, you know, excel. Then there are those who yearn to go out there and look for that fatherly love, look for that yes. fatherly figure. And that mm-hmm. is when the situations get intense. It gets into yes. serious, you know, causes, you know, and right. you try now as a mother trying to pull back your child, but it's too late. Yes. It's already too late because they already got so influenced with what is going on outside. They got mm-hmm. feed into the nice words, the nice things that they are hearing or seeing, you know, and when before you know it, you lost them.
Yes, you know? And what I've...
So it's always, as you said, is the mental health thing. It's so, everything is, the battle is always here in the mind.
Right, you know? And if you think about it, if you look at all the religions out there and all of the cultures, men are dominant, regardless if it's financial, economic, yep. physical, and women are submissive. So how yeah. can a young man grow up with a maternal or feminine figure and not be stomped on, abused, or bullied, or what have reprimanded in a society when it's predominantly patriarch?
Yeah.
And that goes yeah. with cultures, and that goes with, you know, your environment. I talk about in this book, in the index, is actually the steps that of the path less traveled that I call press play. Plan yeah. life according to you, LLC. Mm-hmm. Because we all can say that we, if you don't face your past will continue to chase you, correct?
Yeah.
But are we looking forward? I had a conversation with someone a couple of weeks ago about how the different cultures, they're in some cultures, I believe, and I'm, pardon me if I'm incorrect, but I believe it was Buddhist and monks, that they teach their children and act in the present, but consider seven to 10 generations out, the repercussions or consequences or result of what they're doing today.
Oh, wow.
And if we have that mindset, mm-hmm. if we look at, okay, what am I doing today to contribute? How could I serve you and how could we serve each other? But in the long run, the future generations thereafter.
Yeah. 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 Very, very good. Very good. Oh, my gosh. We have to talk more.
Absolutely. No, I am available.
It's really, really interesting. Hearing you speak for the first time, actually face to face. And, you know, because this was so long overdue. It was supposed to be listening to you so long. And now hearing you for the first time with all these, you know, interesting topics, interesting views. It have you mind boggling to say, wow, is this really happening? Is that really happening?
Right.
You understand? So, and I'm sure the listening audience, they are like, oh, wow. You know, they could attest to what you, you know, are saying. They could recognize what it is you're saying. And so true, you know. So,
and in today's world, we're constantly confused because we're shifting the mindset of generations. We're shifting the mindset and identity of who we are as human beings. Rather than saying, I am a checked box, which checkbox do I conform to? Say, I am, and complete that sentence with your name. Complete that sentence with your ancestry. Complete that sentence with your message and mission. And I just fortunately have AM as my initial. So I am Andrea Mason. But what does that mean to people? That means a social, somebody who's dedicated their lives to social work and psychology for 2 decades, a global ambassador where I'm working with 2 other women of Africa, raise a peace ambassador to shift the changes of all quadrants in Africa to help and assist and make aware globally sex-based gendered crimes for women and children, to help individuals bring the world together on a virtual global platform that will resume in September of dignitaries and pillars of their communities worldwide, saying, you know what? Here's a connection. Here's a resource to those who don't have access. or to provide a book or coaching that I provide as an accountability coach and a solution specialist strategist. What does that mean? You have goals, dreams, and aspirations you have yet to fill. I'm sure you have 9 or 10 that are unfinished, but what do? I don't dictate. I don't lecture. I listen. Unconditionally love, and we together we create strategies to achieve those goals ahead of your deadlines. Why? Dreams don't have deadlines. They create the destinations.
Amen. Nice, nice, nice. So our time is going. Any last words?
Yes, absolutely. Last words until we meet again is to remember this from my heart. Anything you've gone through gives you the certification and ability to help others achieve it too. And remember, always, 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 that Les Brown said, he'll quote me.
Yes.
Follow your heart, not the herd nor the hurt, for success and joyfulness are on the other side. And the reason, other side, pardon me. And the reason why I say follow your heart, not the herd, because it could be however you take it. Herd being the masses of everybody telling you how to live your life, or herd what you hear on social media on what you should be based on your gender, culture, ethnicity, socioeconomic status, as well as your role.
Wow. That is powerful. There you have it. There you have it. Andrea Mason. I'm so glad that you came on. I'm so glad that I met with you. I have to talk to you after.
Absolutely. Yes. I welcome everybody.
I'm sure the listening audience, I'm sure the comments are good and they really enjoyed you. Thank you so much for coming on. Thank you so much for viewing, right?
Listening
audience. As you said, she put up her info there. You can reach out to her. She's on Linktree. And you can, whatever you need, whatever it is, just reach out to her. She is there to assist and she will guide you on the right path.
Yes.
Again,
and
thank you again.
Yes. And I just put the link for my gift. So if you put the powder room, so I know where you came from, I will gift you a 30-minute complimentary discovery call to see where you are.
Great. Thank you so much.
Yes.
Thank you all for listening. Bye. Thank you.
Hi, this is Liselle Powder from The Powder Room. Join me every fourth Sunday and fourth Monday at 8 p.m. for poetic therapy, poetry that speaks life. Stay tuned for more.